I want to live in Kenya until I die.
Oh, wow.
Hey, man, killers, what are you doing? You say, I'm outside. When you're Mzungu, Mzungu means what?
Can you just say some few words in Kiswahili?
Hi, guys. Welcome back to my Killers channel.
Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. It's your boy Man Keman Kilitz here once again with another video. Thank you so much for clicking, and if you're new here, please consider subscribing and turn on notification bell icon. So today I have my visitor in my channel, and the name is...
My name is Matt Diamond. I'm from the US.
Which state?
I grew up in Missouri, middle of the map.
Yeah.
And then I moved to Oklahoma in 2019 to start planning my future Kenyan life.
Yeah. Oh. So Diamond, you came to Kenya. Why did you choose Kenya?
Oh, okay. So Kenya, you know, there's 54 countries on the continent of Africa.
Yeah, true.
Kenya is the most welcoming by far. I don't think there's even a competition.
Yeah. Wow.
So I had a lot of friends inviting me to come, and I had like this health issue with my stomach. And all Africans, not just Kenyans, but all Africans kept saying, just come to Africa and eat our food, and you're going to feel better.
So when you came to Africa, all your problems ended with the stomach?
Yeah, basically. the problems come back only when I go to the U.S.
Oh.
Yeah, when I'm here, I get better and better, my stomach's good, and I just keep gaining kgs. I'm a small guy, but I've been smaller. When I wasn't well, I was smaller. So like right now, I'm really happy with my kgs,
You're looking good.
Karibu.
So when did you come to Kenya?
2018. It was September 2018. I went into Nairobi, and from there, I came right here, where we are now, to Fisheries.
Sky Lounge. Yeah, guys.
The capital city of Bamburi.
The capital city of Bamburi. So guys, you have to shoot this video at the place that we choose, because this is a memorable place for you.
This is the first place I
that
ever
you
took
came
a drink
to Mombasa.
In Coast. Yeah, and my friend let me stay like just a small distance from here.
Yeah.
I took my first ugali across the road.
You have ever tasted ugali?
I love ugali.
Wow.
That's how I get the stomach.
So Mr. Diamond, Matt Diamond, what was the best experience so far? You living in Kenya, what's your best experience ever?
You know, there's so many good ones.
Uh-huh.
I'll just, I guess a simple one, it's something you do every day. You go outside. Yeah? And like Westerners, you know, you don't say, hey, man, kill us, what are you doing? You say, I'm outside. You don't say it that way.
Yeah.
But here, you know, when you say you go outside, it means you're in the streets, you know, just outside this place. And I love the energy.
And
I love the energy. It can fix the bad mood. You know,
like the matatu thing.
Yeah, the matatu is colorful, it's lively, people are friendly. Being a Mzungu, I think people are maybe a little bit friendlier. But generally, comparing American culture to here, even you guys are so friendly to each other. I hear that you're not, but I see that you are.
Yeah.
You guys aren't so bad.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Yeah.
So what has been your worst experience or something bad?
It makes me very tired. So when you're a Mzungu, Mzungu means what?
White man.
When you're a white man, white woman, and you go in the streets, you go outside, some people think that you're just full of money and there's a money tree in your house. But the truth is, you know, we gotta hustle and work too. I can't speak for everyone, but for me, I hustle, I work. I'm not a rich man. I'm a working man, you know? So sometimes people give you bad price.
So when you go to buy... They think you're filthy rich.
Yes, you buy a tomato, they can charge you triple. You buy a shirt or a kofia, a hat, and they can try to charge you triple. So, you know, you have to learn how to deal with that.
So, how did you manage to deal with that thing? The pricing,
you know,
thing,
the first,
after staying a while in Kenya.
Yeah, the first time I was in Kenya was 41 days, and I almost always had a friend escorting me.
Oh.
So it couldn't happen so much.
Yeah, true.
My second time was like a test of can I live here on my own. So I was going out in the streets alone, I'm buying things alone, I'm getting coach alone, I'm getting my tattoo alone.
Wow.
And you learn many hard lessons. But once you learn, things become a little bit better. And the more you learn the language and the culture and the way things are around, people respect it, and I respect that about Kenyans, that you give respect, they give respect.
True.
And that's a very important principle, I think, yeah.
So since you've said you've learned some little language, hey, can you just say some few words in Kiswahili?
Najua Kiswahili kidogo sana.
Uh-huh.
It's really not a lot, but I know like many, many small words.
You can say just some few words.
Yeah, kabisa, salama, naende.
Shikamo.
Maharaba. I don't know that one. Habari ya leo.
Habari ya leo.
Hey, asubuhi, nzuri. Yeah. Siko and jema, siko and
wow! Those are enough. Yeah,
but if someone gives me a whole sentence, yeah, kabisa, yote,
yeah.
The whole thing, all of it, I won't get. But I can get small.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah.
So, since you've stayed in Kenya so much,
yeah,
what was the best or the tastiest food you have ever tasted here in Kenya?
Oh, man.
You can just say one.
One?
Yeah.
Can I say three?
You can say more.
Okay. I'm going to cheat.
No problem.
Ugali and stew is one.
Uh-huh.
Ugali with stew. Yes.
Meat stew.
It could be no meat. Hapana nyama.
Hapana nyama, yeah, no meat.
Yeah, it could just be tomato, uh-huh, with red pepper, black pepper, onion, garlic.
Wow.
Very nice with ugali. Pojo.
Pojo? Ah, you've just said pojo.
Yeah, pojo.
Have you ever eaten chapati?
Yes, pojo, yes, with chapati.
Wow.
Chapo.
Chapo, hey, wow.
Chapo with sausage, but that's not my pick.
That's not sausage, chapati, the round one. Yeah. The round one?
Yeah, the round one.
Yeah.
But you know the chapati with sausage inside.
Oh.
Add chili sauce. I learned it in my book.
Wow.
Yeah. My third selection, let me just say samaki.
We have the fish.
Fish. Yes, so in Kenya you get lots of tilapia,
yeah,
which
from
is
Lake
nice.
Victoria.
Yeah, Lake Victoria, Kisumu side. And it's really, really nice. But when you move around, and especially in coast, you eat red snapper, white snapper, barracuda,
taffy, una,
catfish.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I love the fish. The saltwater fish, the freshwater fish is very good.
Okay, Matt. So what's your future plans about Kenya? Are you staying here or are you going back to Missouri?
Hey, the first two times I stayed, I hated to leave. It was a heartbreaker. It was a heartbreaker to leave,
yeah,
because I enjoy it here on many levels. So this time I've extended my visa once.
Oh, wow.
And then I'm going to work on doing another extension or a renewal, whatever I got to do. Immigration is kind of tricky, but I want to stay for at least 1 year this time. And I want to start treating the U.S. like I was treating Kenya. I want to visit the U.S. and live in Kenya.
You want to live in Kenya?
I want to live in Kenya till I die.
Oh, wow.
Hey. I'm serious.
Wonderful. So, you have a YouTube channel, a website. You can tell people to follow you and subscribe to you.
Yeah, so you can YouTube me at Matt Diamond Flicks. Or if it's easier, just go to Google. Matt Diamond Flicks, F-L-I-X. You'll find me on IG, Facebook, YouTube, and I also have mattdiamondflicks.com where I write long stories. On mattdiamondflicks.com, you can get a whole story about my first and second visit here. And how I took this place, how I took Africa, how I took Kenya, how I took Uganda. And what makes me like it here so much?
I'm gonna leave the links below the description box. Guys, thank you so much for staying with us till the end of the video. I really appreciate it. Thank you so much, and I'll catch you in my next video. Bye.
Asante sana.
Asante sana. Check 1, 2, mic testing.
The noise. Oh my god. The noisy. Motorbikes.
Where, huh? Alafu ukishika hivi, wajua ukishika hivi unakava hii microphone. Sauti yote inakuja hivi, ina bounce kwa mic. Unashika tu hivi.
You get sponsored, then you start doing this.
Yeah, I show them, man.
Yeah, and I'm trying to get there. I'm trying to get, like, these companies to sponsor. So when you make an interview, you feature their product.
Can I start now?
Yeah, good. It's recording.